As soon as you step into the world of Fury, a new third-person action game from French developer The Game Bakers, its manga influences are immediately apparent. This is in no way an accident. Fury bleeds things like Afro Samurai in its over-the-top action with an emphasis on dueling and especially the flowing, colorful art style. In fact, Afro Samurai creator Takashi Okazaki designed all of the Guardians, using a very similar theatrical approach. There's even a Kuma-inspired character with a rabbit mask for a head. The studio's co-founder, Emmerich Thoa, told me that Fury came out of his determination to make his dream game, one that would focus on intense duels against enemies that weren't the massive hulking beasts you might encounter in things like the Dark Souls series. Thoa was inspired by his days as an amateur boxer back in France. He envisioned Fury's boss fights as one-on-one standoffs, where one false move could mean the difference between victory or defeat. And in more than just the excellent electronic music from Carpenter Brutt, the game indeed demands a dance of perfect footing and technique between two partners. Fury is as much about rhythm as it is your ability to aim, shoot, and dodge. In this way, the game's Japanese influences are more than one. Thoa really wants the game to be a return to the fast-paced action and highly responsive controls of Japanese titles like Devil May Cry and Bayonetta. Reaction time and quick wit are absolutely key to defeating any boss in this game. Much of my time with Fury at PAX East 2016 perfectly played out like a boxing match. As I entered the arena to face off against the game's first guardian, what this game calls a boss. An intimidating, masked opponent that could spew electricity from his fists, which I fell victim to more than once. Thoa coached me, as if this were my big pay-per-view fight in Las Vegas. He instructed me to stay as far away as possible from the guardian in the first stage of the fight. What I faced was a colorful but deadly bullet hell that I had to dodge at all costs while also laying down my own fire with the right stick. You can fire in quick bursts of blue laser beams or with a more deadly long-range shot that quickly staggered my opponent. The close quarters combat was a lot more punishing, as I had to quickly memorize the Guardian's attack patterns. I died a lot trying to do this. The early sections of the fight were way more defensive, mostly because I couldn't get close to my enemy without swinging at nothing but air. These guys are really fast. The tension of these boss fights never subsides, and they'll definitely make you sweat. Thoa wants the duel to feel rewarding, and that's exactly how it felt to finally take down my enemy for good after 30 minutes of fighting.